Hello everyone. For those who do not know me, my name is Regina and I am a Verbum Day missionary disciple. I work in Manila and I work as a teacher in Pamantasan ng Lungsod ng Manila, and at the same time I partner with the campus ministry as we have been having our School of the Word there for quite some time. So I'm happy to be here. Let us begin this School of the Word with an opening prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Father Jesus, Holy Spirit, and our dear Mother Mary, we thank you for the gift of this time of prayer. Thank you for calling us to a prayer where we can really feel you very near, where we can experience your presence, where we can hear you, and where we can also express to you what we have and what we carry in our hearts. We ask your grace, especially the help of our dear advocate, the Holy Spirit, to teach us how to pray, to enjoy a deeper experience of faith that will transform us from within, so that we can see and acknowledge that we can be bearers of your love, of the love of God for others, especially for people he placed in our hands. And Mother Mary, we also ask you to accompany us, be with us, teach us how to stay faithful in our time of prayer. Teach us how to put our part and our whole presence, especially this time. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Last Wednesday was a beautiful experience of being entrusted with a capacity to choose. Yes, to choose life and love, to choose light over darkness. I do not know about you, but the School of the Word is transforming me to really be formed in order to be more and more responsible in taking care of this capacity to give life and to love. I was thanking Jesus. I was thanking him for this life of faith and for the gift of growing in knowing him, because these days are really asking us to concretely exercise love and activate our sense of discipleship, of being formed not by anyone else but by Jesus himself. Because if not, we will end up making the wrong turns and decisions which we are confronted each day. So Jesus, I realize that he is a God who asked us to practice choosing. So I am sure that these past days have given us a taste of this practicum of choosing and deciding to love a bit more, to be more understanding, to perhaps smile more, be more patient. I'm sure that you're already exercising that capacity to choose, to be nicer and kinder, to choose life and to choose love. How to concretely do this is really our day-to-day challenge in our family matters, in issues at work. We are confronted with this choice like, will I get up and exercise? Will I forgive this person? How will I face this workmate who is so annoying? Many decisions. Will I finally get the vaccine? Will I look for a healthier work environment? Or will I be able to really stop this toxic addiction to binge watch or to this online games, etc.? And the good news is, yes, we can. We can choose life and love. But what is this love that we are called to choose? Don't you wonder why every time we see someone who is hurt, we cannot help but attend to that person, ba? Na-feel din natin, no? Nasasaktan sila. Now that the pandemic has somehow deprived us of seeing each other, there is this longing, no? Miss na natin yung isa't isa, to share, to laugh with one another, our kwentuhan, our exchange of stories, etc. Why? Because love is expressed as we connect. Love is expressed as we laugh, as we share a meal, as we relate with one another. That is why also when someone hurt us or lied to us, disappoint us, cheat us, betray us, we also get affected. That is how sensitive we are of love. Why are we sensitive? Why are we sensitive to love? Well, this love is our very essence. Who among us cannot relate to love? Patok na patok sa ating palagi yan, di ba? Yung tema na love. But you know what? I realized that when we look at a newborn baby, for example, in its fragility, smallness, and helplessness, right there and then, I grasp, you know, the reality that none of us could have survived without care, without love. When I look at my parents these days and I see them in their more advanced years now, but you know what makes my mother still glow, okay, with love is to be with my father, especially these days. She expresses it more. And the love that they share, I realize, brought me to life. I mean, we are all here because we are loved. When we are created, we were made out of love. And that is why we are very sensitive to love. Love is our origin. Scientists and scholars can point to the origin, can really explain to us different theories that we came from a powerful Big Bang or that we evolved from other living beings. But deep down, we know that we all came from a life and love giver. Yes, and that life and love giver is none other than our God, our Father. God is our origin. We are formed in His image and likeness, as we hear in Genesis 1:26. Love has a face, and He is our Father. If I'm going to ask you now, do you relate to God as your Father? When you were a child, who is God for you? As we observe now, we can see how some kids will look at God and will really have an impression of God as a powerful being, that sometimes parents use in order to tame them a little bit, no? To control their being makulit, no? And their being malikot. So allow me to share to you who God is for me as a kid. Well, as a child, I relate to God every time I need something. God, for me, is someone who grants my wish. That is why my prayer as a child is a list of the things that I like. Sabihin ko sa kanya, Lord, bigyan mo naman sa akin yung tao na nabibilin yung cute Sanrio purse na gustong-gusto ko, o kaya yung bibilin yung huggable pillow, no, na gusto ko. Or please, Lord, convince mo naman yung mama ko na nakunin na yung puppy na binibigay ng kapitbahay namin. And to my surprise, most of the times, no, all the ones that I put on my surprise list will be granted. But fast forward to now, how do I relate to God as my Father? Know what I realized? This time I have become more and more familiar with Him. And unlike before when I just approach Him every time I need something, now I can share with him everything. My ups and downs, my happy moments, my not so happy moments, what frustrates me, what makes me sad. And the more I get old, the more and more I learn that his heart becomes bigger. It is up until now, no, that I know that my God, my Father, listens to me very attentively. How about you? Now that you are an adult, has that image of God changed? If you are to picture him now, how would he look like? Is he a good-natured and pleasant-looking father for you? Or he is a domineering and more serious-looking God? Or do we look at him as distant, no? A distant figure who watch over us and really waits, no, when we will commit, no, with looks at all our dealings and what we do and wait until we make a mistake. God the Father creates us in order that we may relate with him as our tatay, as our papa, as our father. For you, what does an ideal father looks like? For some of us, our biological parents are our heroes, our models. And it is somehow easier in understanding God as loving and kind if we also had that kind of experience, or if we also have loving and kind parents. Or it would not be difficult to picture God as our protector, as someone who consoles us, if we have generous, if we have very caring caregivers while growing up. It can be not our parents, but it can be our lolo or lola. But you know what? God, our Father, is so much more than any ideal parent that we can think of. God is much, much more than any of the ideal parent that we have in our standards. Yet for some of us, we may not be so fortunate to have good parents or good grandparents, because yes, there is no perfect family after all. Hence, God the Father sends good people into our lives to show us love and kindness. Yeah. You know what, when I was in kindergarten, I had a very fun and cool religion teacher. So we like him very much because, every lesson with him is filled with laughters, as he would crack jokes in between and would tell his own stories of how he relates with God. But perhaps in your case, it is not a teacher, but a good priest, or a very good mentor, a very good coach. It can be your uncle, your aunt. It can be your kuya or your ate. Someone who came along. Someone who extends God's loving hands and protection in your life. Behind these people is the face of God. Behind these people, it's the face of God as our tatay, as our papa. They are his image and likeness. The thing is, we have failed to, or we have not just acknowledged that all these are his gestures of kindness and love for us. So today in our prayer, I invite you to thank God for having always been here, although we have failed to recognize it. All along, Father, you were with me, and I did not know. In Genesis 28, verses 11 and 17. And this is where I will invite you to draw, no, our reading for this school of the word, or for our prayer. Again, Genesis 28, verses 11 to 17. Allow me to read this passage. When he had reached a certain place, referring to Jacob, He stopped there for the night, since the sun had set. Taking one of the stones of that place, he made it his pillow and lay down where he was. He had a dream. There was a ladder planted on the ground with its top reaching to heaven, and God's angels were going up and down on it. And there was Yahweh standing beside him and saying, I, Yahweh, am the God of Abraham and your father, and the God of Isaac. The ground on which you are lying I shall give to you and your descendants. Your descendants will be as plentiful as the dust on the ground, and you will spread out to the west and the east, to north and south, and all clans on earth will bless themselves by you and your descendants. Be sure I am with you. I shall keep safe wherever you go and bring back to this country, for I shall never desert you until I have done what I have promised you. Then Jacob awoke from his sleep and said, truly Yahweh is in this place, and I did not know. He was afraid and said, how awe-inspiring this place is. This is nothing less than the abode of God, and this is the gate of heaven. Now in this passage, Jacob came to realize that surely the Lord is in this place, and I was not aware of it. I could relate very well with Jacob's experience with God. The past months had been challenging. I'm sure all of us, no exemption. But in my case, it has been extra challenging since the beginning of this year, especially with the case of my mother, because he was diagnosed with a kidney failure. To have a member of a family getting sick in this time of pandemic is very hard. There were many times I felt worried. I felt very sad and worried. I felt I was like a sheep without a shepherd. I felt I lost my way towards the pasture. There were days like that. So on the day that we brought my mama to the emergency room until she was discharged from the hospital, God has proven time and again that he was very much involved, and he closely accompanies me and my mother on those days. Isa sa mga strong proof or expression of God's presence these days is when he sent us the doctor na nag-operate kay mama. I knew it was God who is assuring me that the same way that he assured Jacob in his dream that he was with me all along. The doctor attended to my mother said, Nanay, hindi po ako usually nag-ooperate sa ER first time. Ikaw yung unang pasyente na ginawaan ko ng procedure. Hearing those words from the doctor right there and then melted my heart, because it was like receiving a big hug from God, because I have been praying very hard. Lord, siya na po yung doktor na ibigay mo sa amin when everything started, because doon na mas komportable yung mama ko. And my mother happened to have some issues when it comes to procedures, being in the hospital and such. And it was answered. And you know what, from the operation to the procedure hanggang sa lumabas na kami, may pahabol pa si God. Well, na-surprise, because that same surgeon who operated my mother offered help. He said that why don't we stay a bit more because he is willing to come back very early the next morning for the next procedure. We were supposed to be discharged first and then we admitted. But the doctor said, huwag na po, kasi it would cost you extra, and it would be very inconvenient for your mother and yourself, because once you went out of the hospital and get back again for the next procedure, you'll have to go over again, the same process, so mag-antay na naman ulit kayo, mapapaswab na naman ulit kayo, and we don't know what will happen. Wow. So, for me, I felt that God really never left me and my mother. He had always been there as my shepherd. And you know what, as I reflect on this passage reading that we have, these vivid scenes that happened a few months ago became very, very much alive again. As a manifestation of God as my Father accompanying me as His helpless child, as His lost child. And you know what, I realized that like Jacob, I realized that God has always been there. I just didn't realize it. But yes, the moment that I allow God to accompany me, no, the moment that I allow Him to reveal His ways to me, the moment that I allow Him to just reveal His stories to me through His Word, is the only way that I would know that He is present. All I needed is to respond as what Jacob did when he went his way to where his father is asking him to go. We only need to see that way for us. We only, like Jacob, we only need to see that the way for us to embrace our loads, our worries, and our anxieties, our burdens, is when we do not struggle with our arms and shoulders. Di ba ganun yun? No? Kapag masyado mabigat yung mga burdens that we carry, we really carry it on our shoulders, and we really put a lot of our effort using our hands, we really struggle a lot. No? There's a lot of effort in trying to lift these heavy loads. Parang ang bigat-bigat. Pero kapag niyakap natin our loads, our burdens, our crosses, when we embrace them, mas magaan. And today, let us recall all the faces of the people who made us lift our loads, who embraced with us our loads, and made us felt loved and supported. In my experience, I saw God in the kindness of my and care of my mother's attending surgeon, and through that concrete experience, I felt that God, the Father, is embracing my load, is embracing my cross with me, and I am sure as well that you had similar encounters in your life. So this time of prayer is the best moment to recall the kind faces, those very supportive people who showed you generosity, who showed you, who offered you help. It can be, a friend who just recently embraced with you, no, a heavy load. Or a random person who suddenly offers you out of nowhere a favor, or the prayers that we have been receiving these days. You know, my mother's mood has really improved tremendously from the onset of her condition to now. And I believe that mood of joy and of being more relaxed these days, of being less masungit these days, are all results of your constant prayers. You have all been praying a lot for my mother, my co-disciples, and my dear missionaries. And I thank you so much for that. Just please keep my mother continuously in your prayers. And yes, in your life too. God has been faithful. He had been in your life all along. In silence, today, in this moment of prayer, our time with our Papa, with our God the Father, let us give thanks to all these people who offered help, who showed us that God is very near, that God is embracing us, embracing the loads with us, who keeps on cheering us that we can be a better version of ourselves. Those people are a concrete manifestation of God's love and care. behind them is that embrace of God. Behind them is a loving Father who makes us lift lightly all our crosses and the loads that we carry. Turn to our loving God. That is my invitation to you in this time of prayer. Like Jacob, let us acknowledge that God, our Father, has always been with us all along. Let us start to rekindle again our father and child bonding in this time of prayer. We have a very loving, a gentle, a kind Father who is true to His promise. Let us spend time with Him. Let us enjoy being His child. Let Him pamper us, console us. Let Him be our Father, because He has been longing for us as His child. Father, we want to say sorry for the times that we were not able to recognize right away that You are very near and that You are present in the details, in the circumstances of our lives. Teach us today to lay down again to You all our worries, all our questions, all our troubles, especially the ones that we weigh us down. May we be able to listen more with our hearts in this time of prayer and enjoy the truth that we are Your children. May we be able to really savor that identity of ours as Your child. As we pray, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name, Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. Magandang araw sa inyong lahat. Ako po pala si Algie, Lachica na taga Marikina City. Alam natin na ang Diyos ang naglikha sa atin. Naniniwala tayo na siya ang tunay nating magulang, hindi dahil ito'y nakasulat o sinabi lang sa atin. Kaya tayo naniniwala dahil nararamdaman natin ang kanyang pagmamahal. Ngayon, nais kong ibahagi sa inyo kung paano naging magulang ang Diyos sa akin. Pero bago ang lahat, nais kong ibahagi ang passage na ito. Isaiah chapter 49 verse 15. Malilimot kaya ng ina ang kanyang sariling anak? Hindi kaya niya mahalin ang sanggol na iniluwal? Kung mayroong mang inang lumilimot sa kanyang bunso, ako'y hindi lilimot sa inyo, kahit sandali. Ang totoo, sobrang relate ako sa passage na ito. Dahil literal kong naranasan ito. Dahil 3 taon pa lang ako na umalis ang mama ko napuntang Singapore upang magtrabaho. Makalipas lang ng ilang taon, sinabi ng papa ko sa aming magkapatid na hindi na daw uwi ang mama namin. Dahil nagkaroon na siya ng bagong pamilya. At nung ako'y 8 taong gulang, na-aksidente ako kaya kailangan akong maoperahan. Dahil sa walang permanenteng trabaho ang papa namin, halos nabenta namin ang mga gamit namin. Kaya umalis ang papa namin at nagtrabaho siya sa Saudi. Kaya habang lumalaki ako, nahanap ko yung pagmamahal ng magulang. Sobrang hirap kasi wala kang masabihan ng problema. Uuwi ka galing school at trabaho na walang sasalubong sa'yo. Dumating na ako sa point na hindi ko na kaya yung mga pinagdadaanan ko, kaya madalas kong sabihin na ayoko na, suko na ako. Pero bakit nga ba kahit ilang beses ko sabihin suko na ako, kahit patuloy pa rin akong nabubuhay? Dahil hindi siya sumuko sa akin. Oo, lumaki ako ng walang magulang, pero ang Diyos ang naging magulang ko. Sa kanya ko sinasabi ang lahat. At kung wala yung pagmamahal niya, wala na siguro ako dito. Wala man ang mga magulang ko sa tabi ko, marami naman siyang pinadala sa buhay ko para magparamdam ng pagmamahal sa akin. Dinala niya ako sa community na to na pwede kong masabing tahanan ko. Kung dati wala akong masabihan ng experience ko o nararamdaman ko, pero ngayon nababahagi ko ito sa tulong ng Pasigso at ROL. At andyan ang mga sister at mga pare na gumagabay sa spiritual kong buhay. Alam ko na hindi ko may iwasan masaktan at lagi andyan ang problema at kalungkutan. Pero handa na akong harapin ito dahil nagkaroon ako ng pagkakataon na kinausap niya ako sa pamamagitan ng panaginip. At sinabi niya sa akin na lagi siyang andyan para sa akin. Ang tinuro niya sa akin ay kaya tayo nasasaktan ay hindi para makakasakit din ng iba, kundi para tayo ay matutong magmahal. Lord, thank you for being a father to each and every one of us. Thank you for your everlasting love.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. can hardly think as you call me, deeper still as you call.
It's who you are. It's who.